train. Kate Costas.
Kate, what a pleasure.
Likewise, I've been listening to the tapes of all your shows. I love what you're doing.
Thank you very much. I like to think of my show as a haven for the tempest tossed in the maelstrom of everyday life.
Wow, you really talk that way.
Mercedes Rule and I actually had great chemistry on screen. I think the process was a little foreign to her because we rewrite every day. And you know, an actress that comes from the theater is a little more used to sticking with the text they've got. You could tell that she wasn't always comfortable in the process. She was always a million bucks on stage. I mean, when the cameras were rolling, she was spot on and funny and dedicated. I mean, she's a terrific actress. She's one of the best.
I have an idea about the source of our antagonism.
Good. Do let me hear it.
I'm a woman, I'm as smart as you, and I'm your boss.
Coincidences all.
It was a great storyline, and it sort of held up, and I loved the way we fell apart, but I remember one day I was going home from work after it was camera blocking day, and that's sort of late in our process, and as I stood in the middle of a scene, I suddenly realized what was wrong with it, and they had to do a major rewrite, and of course, we were shooting the next day, and I think she was a little dismayed by that one. I said goodnight to her as she was driving by. She didn't say a word to me. I thought, maybe I'm in trouble.
Well, hi-ho the Dario, the cheese stands alone.
The next morning I came in and we were talking a little bit. She came up and said, you know, I've been thinking. I've decided that if I were a man, I would want to be you. To this day, I'm not sure exactly what it means.
Doc, can we hurry this thing up? I got a charity event tonight. She's not much to look at, but what the hell?
Dan Butler is, you can say the same thing about him. Dan and I go way back. We did work together in the old Globe Theater in San Diego, very long time ago. So our relationship of now almost 30 years is very warm and affectionate and mutually respectful. I think he's a fantastic actor. And he certainly grabbed this character, Bulldog, by the balls and sort of did it to a fairly well.
Hey, beat it.
He fears no heights and is always working without a net. It's lovely to watch him work as well.
Gil Chesterton, the restaurant critic. Yeah. Oh, I just love those wicked things you say when the food is bad.
Well, keep bringing these and you won't be disappointed.
Edward Hibbert is a genuine one of a kind. He's the real article. He's authentically himself. He's one of the greatest people I've ever known, and I think great people and great actors kind of come in the same breath.
For those of you who have not yet sampled the punch, here is my capsule review. Vile bouquet, unwholesome color, ghastly taste, and a kick that is simply heaven.
No one can do what he does with a sentence. No one can do what he does with his physicality. He is an extraordinary person and a great addition to the show. I look forward to every time we have him on the show.
What are you two want?
Nothing. Keep up the good work.
Fraser Crane has become a terrific adult, I think. And that's something that, you know, hopefully we all arrive at one day. And I feel kind of blessed that I've been able to play a character who's come to terms with his dad and with his brother and with himself through his 40s.
You know, I've forgotten what a weird little person you are.
I've gotten, by being involved in this show, to experience a set of emotions and a set of relationships that I don't have in real life. And that's a kind of amazing gift.
Good night, everybody.